I also, in 2017, finished my three-year poetry project on the manufacturing history of Berks County. So I had three volumes that I wrote in interviewing seniors from around my area who worked in old factories and mills. And I interviewed them and then write poems from the content. So this is my last volume, and the project is called The Labors of Our Fingertips, Poems for Manufacturing History in Berks County. So, and I did interview as many, I tried to have as many men and women, like, diversely across my numbers as I could, but there were a lot more women I interviewed because there were a lot more women around. So this one is called, the titles are The Name of the Person, the Municipality Where They Live, and the Year They Were Born. So this is Elizabeth Work, Upper Burn Township, born 1943. Just because you take a job doesn't mean you like it, but it can give you experience, skills, knowing that thickly straight difference of what you enjoy, what you don't. I took this away from Rackman Manufacturing Company, its floor is situated at 1135 Moss Street in the city of Reading. The two brothers who ran it, of the Rackman name, were Tobias and Frank. The factory lit up with the blur of machines producing shirts for servicemen. I ran a bar tacking machine. This meant I handled the bottom width of a belt loop. I didn't do the top. The needle jazzed back and forth in quick jumps, securing strong stitches so belts always had a home around the waist of the wearer. It might have been 1962, a few years before our country joined in on the Vietnam War. A straight pin went through my foot at the end of a shift when I stepped away from my workload, piercing right through my shoe. I sat down on the floor. The machinist used pliers to pull it out, all 2 or 3 inches of its polished, jagged little identity making itself known in my distant walking. By 1968 or 1969, I gave a few months of my days at Talbot Knitting Mills in the city, a sewing machine operator, stitching sleeves of especially soft sweaters. Then I moved to Illinois, but I grew my heartstrings back into Pennsylvania by 1984. I took a job at Windsor Knitting Mill Incorporated in Hamburg. My sister, Linda, a floor girl there, helped me to get her same job. I'd run up to her during our shifts sometimes, hug her, kiss her on the cheek. The women knew Linda had a husband, but said I kept getting too friendly with her, not knowing we were family. They called me a lesbian. Linda and I said, let's give them something to talk about. Feeding right back into their assumption land gossip, told them that I competed in professional mud wrestling tournaments on weekends, traveling to Harrisburg, Philadelphia. They were in such awe, would ask me how often I won. Months later, we offered them mud truth. They fumed, balked, blushing in embarrassment. I told them, well, yeah, I'm not a lesbian either.